Perseverance to me is not giving up. Most of my life in a wheelchair has been that. If I would have just said, oh, everything's too hard, I wouldn't have got to the point I am right now. And that's with sports and education, social life, everything. Being that I was a mechanic before I was injured, I didn't know what I was going to do anymore professionally. I kind of struggled to find what was next for me. I went to the first Code Labs 1 course, and that was for software development and coding. Codefi provided me the education necessary to be successful in this career.
In 2014, James Stapleton and Chris Carnell opened Codefi, Cape Girardeau's first co-working space and technology incubator. This was the first technology incubator in the entire Southeast Missouri region. Their goal was to diversify their local economy through tech. Now, let me just mention, these are not your typical economic development guys. They're just two entrepreneurs who love where they live and saw a way to create opportunity in a place they call home.
I think like a lot of rural communities, there wasn't a lot of startup ecosystem in place. There certainly weren't many elements of the digital economy in place. And so I think what people don't understand is those of us trying to do some of this work, you have to create every element and motivate every element of a system to sort of build, attract, motivate more and more technically based companies. I started gathering with Chris and a group of friends 5 or 6 years ago, having conversations about how we might be able to catalyze more activity in tech-based startups.
There was no concerted effort of supporting technology and startups in our area. So we decided to start something ourselves. When we started, this intersection was, there was nothing, it was vacant, dilapidated. The city was actually voting to tear these buildings down. We wanted to create something that basically is life-changing for people. So when you think about tech startups and that sort of economy, you can do that.
Codefi began as a business venture to give entrepreneurs a co-working space to launch new tech-focused ventures. In 2017, the Codefi partners co-founded their own tech startup out of the co-working space. Cargo grew from 2 to 25 employees, supporting hundreds of local drivers in 3 markets in just 3 years.
As startups started to launch here, we started to notice there was a pattern on people saying, we can't find any developers. So that came in about 2 years after James and I started Codefi. So imagine us trying to start a tech and startup space with no talent around.
Only 5% of computer and math occupations employment is in rural counties, despite these same regions representing 15% of our national workforce. That's a big deal because these tech-related jobs, they tend to have a lot more job growth to them, and they also tend to pay a lot more. So when you see our rural communities being left behind to that degree, it's not just about those jobs today. It's about the loss in wages as those wages grow, and the loss in job creation as well.
We can't just train people and they go and leave. So we had to make sure that there's opportunity here. While we're helping tech startups, we're also developing the talent that they have.
There's so much work ethic here and drive. There's just not necessarily always the opportunity to really be on the cutting edge of what our workforce is going to look like in the next couple of decades. So we think that getting these future-ready skills in the hands of folks in rural communities really gives them the tools that they need to be successful as our workforce continues to change.
We have an adult coding program where we basically in 20 weeks can take someone from no prior knowledge to entry-level skills as a developer.
Coding's provided me with the opportunities to have a professional career. I'm a tutor and a mentor for Youth Coding League and also for the Code Labs 1 adult course. The Youth Coding League is an after-school program for kids that are in grade school.
The Youth Coding League, our vision with that is to lower barriers of accessibility, but also reward excellence for the kids who are participating. And we really want to get future-ready skills in the hands of the kids who need it the most.
My name is Show Rust. I'm the founder of Show.ai, and we're an automation company that's focused on branding. We do this currently through a digital playbook that you can edit and customize online. The main reason why I left Cape was to attend Art Center, develop some skill sets, and so eventually I could build something like I'm building today. When I was living in LA, I was living in Venice Beach. I think it was rated as like one of the most expensive places to live in the United States. It's not the most friendly place to like start a company, for example, with that much overhead. Also, there's a lot of chaos and distractions. Coming to Cape Girardeau allows us the ability to focus. A lot of people thought about small towns as lacking the opportunity and the skill sets to produce great tech startups and innovation. We've seen a drastic change in that in the last 5 years. Bootstrapping the business like we did, where we spent 2 years without taking any cash at all, would not have been possible in Los Angeles. And then so we would have been forced to fail or succeed extremely quickly. So we're really excited about immersing ourselves in the tech community further. More than that, showing the community that an innovative tech startup can happen here in Cape Girardeau. And as people see that, we're really excited to have more and more people like us free themselves from the distraction and the chaos that a big city provides.
Innovation can happen everywhere. You don't need huge populations to support small town entrepreneurs. You just need a strong internet connection and innovative people working together to solve problems.